I made my bedroom as toxic as possible to see if my new Ultrahuman Home smart health monitor would actually warn me about it.
Babe, what's that smell?
Nothing, don't worry about it.
But the biggest surprise was discovering something that was already in my bedroom and quietly damaging my brain. Spoiler alert, it's probably in yours too. But first, some context. I know it looks like Apple made a wireless router, but this is actually the Ultrahuman Home. It's a home health monitor that continuously measures health and safety metrics like air quality, environmental comfort, light exposure, and UV exposure in your home. So supposedly, this is able to track and alert you to issues like invisible pollutants, unhealthy CO2 levels, excessive blue light exposure, and so on. And since we spend about 90% of our time indoors, these are factors that can make or break your recovery, sleep, and productivity. The Ultrahuman Home can be used as a standalone device, or you can use it alongside the other products in Ultrahuman's ecosystem, like their smart ring, the Ultrahuman Ring Air. But I can show you how all the products work together later in the video. Because first, we've got to see if this thing even works by making the air in my home as toxic as I possibly can using common household supplies you probably use every day. In case it's not obvious, don't try this at home. Let's get dirty. All right, now let's see what my Ultrahuman Home has to say about all the fun we're having here today. So, after lighting candles, spraying a few chemicals, cooking some smoky burgers, basically making my room a toxic mess, here's what happened. So we start with an air quality score of 88, which is good. You can see that all my metrics were pretty much healthy and in range, minus the room being a little stuffy from my own carbon dioxide. But as soon as I run this experiment and make my room super toxic, boom, air quality score drops all the way down to 45. You can see all these specific pollutants jumping up, mostly into the unhealthy to toxic range. And here's an overall look on my total home score. Air quality went as low as 44, and actually even my environmental comfort and light exposure scores dropped, but that's actually just because I had to turn off my noisy AC and set up a bunch of studio lights to record the experiment. So going back to those air quality scores. First, we've got HCHO, which increased slightly. Now, I didn't even know what HCHO was, so I scrolled down a bit in the app to learn more, which it does for all of these pollutants. And in this case, it lets us know that HCHO is formaldehyde, which I've only ever known to be at funeral parlors, but apparently it's also a really common indoor pollutant from furniture, building materials, and even candles. Then we've got carbon monoxide, which stayed at 0 parts per million, which is good and what I expected since I use an electric stove. Now, if I were cooking with a gas stove, we probably would have seen this go up, so no news is good news. CO2 also crept up a bit, but we'll come back to that later. Then we've got the particulates, and here's where things get scary. So PM1, PM2.5, and PM10 are different sized particulates that affect our health in different ways. The smaller the particle, the deeper it can get into your lungs. PM2.5 is especially nasty because it can even enter your bloodstream. In my case, PM1 hit nearly 400, and PM10 and PM2.5 went completely off the charts. That's from smoke, cooking burgers, my air fryer, and burning bread. So even if your smoke detectors aren't going off, it could still be useful to be notified by Ultrahuman Home that whatever you're cooking might be harmful to your health and you should probably crack a window. We've also got VOCs, or volatile organic compounds, which shot all the way up to 6.06 milligrams per cubic meter. This huge spike came from really normal things like WD-40, scrubbing bubbles, bleach, the diffuser, even my candles. So stuff that you'd never even think of dangerous in small amounts was shooting this up to toxic. And all of that combined made my AQI, or air quality index, skyrocket to 698. Now, for context, anything over 300 outside is considered hazardous, and I managed to more than double that inside my bedroom. But here's the crazy part. The biggest threat to my health wasn't any of the stuff I just sprayed in my home, and it's probably something that's in your room right now. Now, poor air quality isn't the only thing in your home that can negatively impact your health. That's why Ultrahuman Home tracks more than just air quality. It also tracks your home's environmental comfort factors like temperature, humidity, and ambient noise levels, as well as red blue, green, and infrared lights, plus UV exposure. And everything I've tested so far does seem super accurate. When my Ultrahuman Home is inside, I'm proud to say it detects no UV exposure. But the second I bring it out to my patio, I immediately see a huge exposure surge in light and UV exposure, which is good because that's what we'd expect to see. But I don't think that the main selling point of Ultrahuman Home is just its ability to show us all these data points. Like, sure, it is good to know if a certain candle brand is using toxic paraffin wax or when you should open some windows while cooking, but I think the value proposition of the home is amplified significantly if you buy into their system with some of their other products. Ultrahuman's flagship product is their Ultrahuman Ring Air, which is an easy recommendation for me. It's probably my favorite smart ring on the market right now for three big reasons. It's got no subscription fee, it's got more unique features than any other smart ring, and it integrates seamlessly with Ultrahuman's other products all under the same app. And I've got a whole other video up reviewing the Ultrahuman Ring Air, so I'm not gonna dive too deep into that right now. I'll just link to it down in the description. If you don't own one, I highly recommend checking it out. I've got a discount for you down there too, so don't forget to use it. Ultrahuman also has their M1 continuous glucose monitoring program and their newly released blood vision program, which sends a nurse to your house to draw your blood and track more than 100 different internal health metrics. So I'm not a sales rep for this company. This is not a sponsored video. I didn't take any money to make it, but it's hard for me not to think Ultrahuman's ecosystem is insanely cool. They're helping you track your sleep and fitness with the ring, your diet with the M1 program, over 100 biomarkers with blood vision, and then every possible environmental health factor with the Ultrahuman Home. Each trackable metric is just another data point, another piece of the puzzle. And when you take a macro look at the data trends, all integrated into the same app, it becomes a lot easier to see how all these things are connected. You can see how excessive blue light in your home might be affecting your low sleep score, or how too much ambient sound could be increasing your stress levels. But here's the craziest thing I found. The biggest problem in my room wasn't any of the stuff I tested. The worst thing I found out about my home was how stupidly high my home's carbon dioxide levels are according to Ultrahuman Home. I thought the issue was gonna be like mold in the air ducts or something like that, but no, it was carbon dioxide. I thought I was getting plenty of fresh air, but apparently this stuffy one-bedroom condo is a disaster for my mental health. I keep the windows closed all day because I'm in Texas and I need the AC running because it's so hot, but now I see that this is depriving my brain of the fresh oxygen it needs to perform at its best and to sleep soundly through the night. I mean, I think that's a pretty big deal. It's like not giving your goldfish enough water. I need that oxygen and I didn't realize I wasn't getting enough of it because it's really not the sort of thing you get any noticeable warning signs about. It's something I'm going to need to work on now, whether that means cracking a window every now and then or just getting some houseplants. But just having seen this data has been a huge value add for me. For you, it might be something else. Maybe you're not sure why you're waking up throughout the night, but then you see that there are random, short-lived noise disturbances you weren't aware of. Or maybe you notice a huge spike in airborne pollutants every time you run your dishwasher, and that's what's to blame for your daily migraines. I did that recently. I had some plastic melting in there, and I'm pretty sure I breathed in a shit ton of toxins. Is it possible these are issues the Ultrahuman Home could help you discover and resolve? Sure, but I still don't think it's gonna be the right investment for everyone. So let's talk pros and cons and who I think should and shouldn't buy the Ultrahuman Home. By the way, again, this is not a sponsorship, but if this device starts to sound like something you might be interested in buying, I will drop a discount link down below that I'll keep updated with the best current deal possible, and using this link will help support the channel, which I always appreciate. Let's start with the good stuff. First, the Ultrahuman Home itself is fantastic. It's completely silent, the data's accurate, and if you're concerned about privacy, there's actually a switch on the back to block the microphone's audio input, like physically toggle it off, it can't hear you anymore. Also, the app itself works flawlessly. I've only had to set the Ultrahuman Home up one time, and I've unplugged it, like it's unplugged now, to move it from room to room many times, and it reconnects automatically each time, no problem. The app also does a great job of integrating all your home's metrics with the data gathered from Ultrahuman's Smart Ring and their other products. So it's an even better product if you decide to stay within Ultrahuman's ecosystem, which I'm personally a pretty big fan of. But the Ultrahuman Home isn't perfect. One of my biggest critiques right now is that while you can easily view your data on a day-to-day, hour-to-hour, or even minute-to-minute basis, The app doesn't actually let you zoom out to see larger trends like how your scores had improved on a week-to-week or month-to-month basis. And this is kind of a strange limitation for the app to have, especially since the Ultrahuman Smart Ring section of the app already does allow you to take this sort of macro look at your health data. But this is a feature that could be added pretty easily with a software update. So hopefully it's just something that gets added soon. Ultrahuman, if you're watching this, give us that zoom out, give us that macro data. Another obvious con is, of course, the price. Like I said, I do have a discount code down below that I can share to help you guys a little bit, but it's still an expensive product and that's gonna be cost prohibitive to some people. On the plus side, there's no subscription to use the device at all. So once you pay that upfront cost, you've got a full and unlimited access to the data it provides forever. That's pretty good nowadays when everybody's trying to reach in your pocket for a monthly subscription. So all that said, who should or shouldn't buy the Ultrahuman Home? Here's my opinion. I think this is a really cool product, but it's definitely a bit of a luxury item. It does a lot, the data is super interesting, and it all integrates seamlessly into the app, but you've gotta be the kind of person who will actually use the data to make meaningful improvements to your health and living space. You need to be someone who will pay attention to the trends, so like me, you'll recognize things like, my carbon dioxide levels are high every day and I'm not getting enough restful sleep. Maybe I should crack some windows at night. You'll get a lot out of this device if you're a naturally curious person who pays attention to the trends and wants to optimize their health. So is this something I'd recommend to someone like my mother? No, because she's not gonna use it right. But is it something I'd recommend to my biohacker or health conscious friends? Yes, definitely. If you are just beginning your health journey, this probably isn't the device to start with. For those kinds of people, frankly, I'd recommend getting Ultrahuman Smart Ring first. It's a more affordable, subscription-free way to dip your toes into Ultrahuman's ecosystem and make sure it's a good fit before trying their other products. And if you want to know more about their Smart Ring, I've already got a whole other video up about that right here. So check that out, see if you like it, and then consider taking a look at the Ultrahuman Home if you want to unlock even more pieces of the puzzle to your health.